Hi, my name is Will Mastin, and I'm with Local Appetite Farms. We're here in Silver Hill, Alabama. It's a small greenhouse and a field crop production company that I grow vegetables for the restaurant industry, basically. I have a partner, Carl Brantley, who's helped me start this business. We grow on about 3.5 acres. We grow hydroponically. We grow in the field with organic methods, and we grow any other methods we can think of in containers, drip irrigation, raised beds under plastic, and that's the introduction to my farm. We are trying this, the pest exclusion technology that we're using with the shade cloth, because we've had a big problem with caterpillars, moths, chewing insects, and mostly the large-bodied insects that get in and cause a lot of crop damage. And it forces us to have to do something to protect our crops. And the conventional answer has been spraying pesticides on a weekly or biweekly regimen, which is expensive and time consuming. And so we looked for an alternative to this, and seeing some of this research done by Dr. Ayunava with the netting, the bug netting in these high tunnel structures, we decided that we would give it a go on our own high tunnels to see if we could try to cut down on the bugs and the pesticide usage and still bring a good crop to the market. Well, the SARE project that I was involved in was the retrofitting of this high tunnel with this woven shade cloth, as you can see. And what the project entailed was an insect screening using a new material that wasn't traditionally used for that purpose, which is this is a 50% woven shade cloth that we have fastened to the outside of our high tunnels. And it acts not only as a shade screen, but it acts as a bug deterrent, and it actually has been very effective at screening out moths, stink bugs, and leaf-footed bugs, which are three of our biggest pests to all of the crops that we grow. And what we did for the study was to grow a control crop of tomatoes and cucumbers inside of the screened-in structure, and then we grew a control crop on the outside in the field right next to it. Everything was fed the same, irrigated the same, the same cultivars of plants. And once we put the shade cloth on here, we noticed immediately that there was almost 100% reduction in moths, caterpillars, infiltration, and stink bugs. Some other benefits that we weren't expecting were protection from driving rains and some heavy windstorms that came up. This screen actually acted as a buffer for the crops inside of the structure. So that was kind of a bonus that we weren't planning on when we first started the project. The main benefits that we've had using the net screen technology is that we've greatly reduced the amount that we've had to spray for insects inside of the structures. The problem that we've had with moths and caterpillars before we started using this, and that we still have on our outside crops, has really been non-existent inside of the screen structures now. The screens have been, they're not a silver bullet, but they have really cut out all of the caterpillars and the stink bugs and leaf-footed bug issues inside of our high tunnels that were really causing a lot of crop damage and economic loss to us before we installed this this technology. The main challenges that you would have that I would say that we've had with the net, putting the net on these existing high tunnel structures, is that it does cut down on airflow and ventilation, and on hot, still days, it can get very hot and humid inside of the structures. You get a little bit, your pollination is affected a little bit on the tomatoes, and we've had to do some hand mechanical pollination. And one of the biggest issues we've had that we were just looking at is the exclusion of your predatory, your beneficial insects, such as lady beetles and lacewings. They are kept out of the structure, and so the small-bodied insects are still a problem. The aphids, the flea beetles, the white flies, they have been a problem because the beneficial bugs are excluded from inside of our structure. And the small bugs can then just run unchecked, and we have to deal with them using horticultural soaps or other means. We've even introduced some beneficials inside of the structures with some success. The use of mechanical ventilation might be beneficial in this sort of structure, using fans. We've actually installed some fans and some misters inside of some of our structures just to help with the cooling and the ventilation. And reflective shade cloth on the top of the structures is a beneficial. The woven shade cloth can get hot, but the reflective shade cloth on the top really helps keep it cooler inside of the structures. I've learned that timing is critical. One of the problems that we had was we had installed the shade cloth kind of late on the structure, and as such, the leaf-footed bugs had already started showing up and got inside on our crops, and we were able to keep the moths out, but the leaf-footed bugs that had already gotten inside of our structure were then trapped. And so we created a little, basically a insectarium for leaf-footed bugs inside of our structure. And since we weren't applying pesticides for the study inside of there, we had to pick everything off by hand. And we eventually ended up getting overwhelmed by the leaf-footed bugs and the stink bugs that came early season. And that was due to our getting the cloth on in the middle of May, which along the Gulf Coast, the leaf-footed bugs have already shown up. Well, some of the problems that we've had with the screen that we weren't really expecting was just finding the right size screen panels, because the screen only comes in certain lengths and heights. And if you get longer lengths, shipping becomes an issue. Shipping seems to double the cost of everything we have to order through the mail. And so if you have to get large rolls of this material, it's expensive. The material itself is expensive. And this is not necessarily a ready-made, something that comes in a ready-made kit. We had an issue on our end walls, even though we ordered them from the manufacturer of the greenhouse, they didn't fit quite right because we had to have a zipper and a zipper door. And this was kind of new technology, and so that was just kind of one of the bugs that we had to deal with was, you know, our shade cloth didn't quite fit the ends, and we had to do some manipulating to make it work right. This project has really shown its promise for sustainability in a sense that it saves us money and time and not having to do repeated applications of pesticides inside of the structure, as well as the environmental benefits of not having to put all of that stuff into the environment. And really the cost of the shade, the screen, has more than paid for itself in the reduction of labor and pesticides that we've had to use inside of the structure.